Welcome back, dear students. In this class, let us discuss about Thallophyta, nothing but algae. The members of this algae, they wear chloroplast in their cells, and the body of this algae is not differentiated into root, stem, and leaves. So, when the plant body is not differentiated into root, stem, and leaves, then that type of plant body is called as thallus. As these algae, they are wearing the chloroplast in their cells, they will be photosynthetic in nature. So, by the process called as photosynthesis, these members are capable to produce their own food. And hence, how can we define this algae or thallophyta? These members of algae or thallophyta, they are chlorophyllous because they bear chlorophyll in their cells. They are chlorophyllous. They are haloid. Why haloid? Because the plant body and these members cannot be differentiated into root, stem, and leaves. And they are autotrophs. They are autotrophs. Why they are called as autotrophs? Because the members of algae, they can prepare their own food, and hence they are called as autotrophs. And when we look into the habitat of these algae, where do they live? They live usually in freshwater as well as marine waters. So they usually live in freshwater as well as they live in freshwater and marine waters also. But there is some exception here. Some of the algae, they live even on the terrestrial habitat. So terrestrial habitat in the sense they will not be present on the dry surfaces. Usually you might have seen. So when you look at the wet wall or wet rocks or wet tree trunks, then you can find the presence of this algae. Usually pachi in the head territory. Yellally water content in the pachi belt. That pachi is nothing but algae. So apart from the algae living in freshwater and marine water, they will also be growing on some terrestrial surfaces also. Like they are found growing on wet rocks, wet soil, moist tree trunks. So here and all we can find the presence of this algae. And when we look at the structure of algae, most of the algae, they might be unicellular or multicellular in nature. So most of the algae, they might be microscopic also. So they might be microscopic, that is microscopic in the sense those algae which can be seen only through the microscope, which cannot be seen through our naked eyes. They will be very small in their size, and hence we need an instrument called as microscope to look at the structure of algae. So such algae are called as microscopic. Some of them might be microscopic. They are visible only through the microscope. But so there are some other algae. So they can be seen through our naked eyes. So they are called as macroscopic. And these algae, they might be unicellular or multicellular in nature. Unicellular in the sense, those algae which are made up of single cells. So when it is made up of a single cell, then it is called as unicellular. We call it as unicellular. When the algae, it is made up of the plant body, that is thallus body, when it is made up of many cells, then that is called as multicellular in the head. So under this algae, we come across the unicellular algae. And some of the algae, they might be filamentous in nature. They might be filamentous in nature. And some other algae, they might be colonial in nature. So what do you mean by filamentous and colonial? So when we look at the unicellular algae, these are made up of single cells. So example for unicellular is Clandomonas, Spirulina, as well as Chlorella, these are all the single cell algae. So these are all made up of a single cell. So that comes under unicellular algae. And some other algae, what happens? The cells of these algae, they will be forming a thread-like structure. So some of the cells, they will be aggregated together at a place to form a thread-like structure like this. And that type of algae is called as filamentous algae. So we call it as filamentous. Why? Because many cells of the algae have been arranged to form a thread-like structure. So that is called as filamentous algae. So filamentous algae can be seen in case of Spirogyra. Here we can see. Also, it can also be seen in Lilothrix and etc. So here what happens in case of spirochaea and Dilophilus, many cells will be present one below the other like this to form a filament. It is thread-like structure that is called as filament. So that is called as filamentous algae. In some other cases like wall box and hydrodictyon, what happens here is these cells will be arranged to form the colonies. So for example, if this is the wall box, here these cells will be arranged together at a place to form the colonies like this. What are the So in the same way, what happens here? Some of the algal cells, they will be present at a place, they will be concentrated at a place to form the colony. So that is called as colonial algae. An example for that is wall box as well as hydrodictyon. And whatever the type of algae it might be, all the algae, the body of the algae, it is the thallus of algae, it is covered by the mucilage to avoid the decay. So the thallus or algal body, it is covered by the mucilage. So what is the purpose of this mucilaginous covering to the plant body here? Just to avoid the decay. I told you these algae, they will be present in fresh water, marine water, wet rocks, moist treatments. But what is common here is algae are usually found in water places or water bodies. So when the algae is present in the water itself, there is a high chance of getting decayed. The plant body gets decayed. But to avoid that, what happens? The body of these algae is covered by a mucilaginous sheet. So that the decay of the algae will be avoided. And when we look at the reproduction of these algae, what happens? Here we can find vegetative propagation, asexual reproduction as well as sexual reproduction. So reproduction in algae takes place by vegetative propagation, and vegetative propagation takes place by fragmentation. It takes place by fragmentation. What do you mean by fragmentation? So here what happens? There is a filamentous algae. Due to some conditions, what happens? There will be a breakage of this filament. That time what happens? When the parent plant body is broken into small pieces, and those are called as fragments. And each fragment or each piece of this parent cell or algae, what happens? This develops into a new individual. So that is called as fragmentation. And in algae, the stage of propagation takes place through fragmentation. Each and every fragment, it develops into a new individual. Okay. And reproduction also takes place by asexual means. So asexual reproduction is also seen in algae. And asexual reproduction takes place by the formation of different types of spores. So here in algae, we come across different types of spores like zoospores, aplanospores, hypnospores, achinets. These are the different types of spores through which asexual reproduction takes place in the thallophyta. And sexual reproduction also can be seen in case of algae. So here in case of algae, that is thallophyta, sexual reproduction is also seen. So what do you mean by sexual reproduction? Sexual reproduction is nothing but the fusion of male and female gametes takes place. So here what happens in algae? The fusion of male and female gametes takes place. But sexual reproduction takes place in three types. So here we come across three types in sexual reproduction. That is isogamous type, or it can be called as isogamy. And one more is anisogamy and oogamy. Or you can also call it as oogamous type of sexual reproduction. Oogamy. So the sexual reproduction takes place by the fusion of male and female gametes. So let me write the diagrams to show the different means of sexual reproduction. In isogamous type, what happens is the fusion of male and female gametes takes place. But the fusion of similar type of gametes takes place. Similar in the sense, here both male and female gametes will be similar in terms of their size, the female gamete and if this is the male gamete, what happens? The fusion between them occurs. And to look here, both male and female gametes are similar in their shape, size, and both are possessing the flagella. So flagella is nothing but a thread-like structure which helps in the movement of these spores or gametes. So that is called as flagella. So when the fusion of similar gametes takes place, when there is a fusion of similar gametes takes place, then that type of sexual reproduction is called as isogamy. And isogamy can be seen in case of spirogyra. It can be seen in case of the spirogyra. So when we look at the anisogamous type of sexual reproduction or anisogamy, here the fusion of dissimilar gametes takes place. Dissimilar gametes here fuses to form the zygote. So that is called as anisogamy. What do you mean by dissimilar? Here, if this is the female gamete or male gamete, what happens is either male gamete or female gamete. So any one of the gametes will be larger in size. They will be larger in size. And one more gamete, whether it might be a female gamete or male gamete, it will be smaller in size. It will be smaller in size, but both possess flagella. So here the number of flagella depends upon the type of algae here. So it might be having only one flagella or two flagella, the number it varies between the species. But here what happens in anisogamous type of reproduction, what happens is one of the gametes will be larger in size and the other one will be smaller in size. And when these two gametes, which are dissimilar in their shape and morphology, fuses, that is called as anisogamy. And this can be seen in case of Chlamydomonas. Chlamydomonas is an example for showing anisogamous type of reproduction. Now let us move on to the oogamy or oogamous type of reproduction. Here what happens is, female gamete will be larger non-motile. Non-motile in the sense, the female gamete will not be having any flagella to move. So if the gametes are possessing flagella, that is thread-like structure, the gametes will move from one place to the other. That is the means of movement here. So if it is lacking the flagella, then that is called as non-motile. In oogamous type, what happens is a female gamete will be large and it is non-motile in nature. Non-motile in the sense, the female gamete will not possess any flagella for the movement. And male gamete here will be small. It will be small and possess the flagella. So when a large non-motile gamete, female gamete, fuses with the small motile gamete, then that type of sexual reproduction is called as oogamy. So here, this is the female gamete. This is the female gamete and this will be the male gamete. This will be the male gamete. So how do you define oogamy? Well, a large non-motile yet or female gamete fuses with a small motile male gamete, then that type of sexual reproduction is called as oogamy. And oogamy can be seen in case of wallworts, it can be seen in case of wallworts, and it can also be seen in case of fucus. It can also be seen in case of fucus. And when we look at the sex organs in these algae, the sex organs in algae, they are not jacketed in nature. So what do you mean by that? The sex organs here in case of thallophyta, they are non-jacketed in the sense the sex organs are not covered by a wall. So that is called as non-jacketed sex organs are present in case of thallophyta. And an embryo stage is absent here. So in sexual reproduction, I told you fusion of male and female gametes takes place. And after the fusion of male and female gametes, a diploid zygote is formed, no doubt in that. But in other plants, what happens is after the formation of zygote, embryo stage is seen. But here in case of algae, embryo stage is absent. This is very, very important. In case of algae, the embryo stage is absent. It is totally absent. But the diploid zygote is functional. That will directly grow into a new individual.